Welcome to Into the Fire. I'm Rob Reed, President of Bison Fire Protection, and I believe that together we can make the world a safer place. So every week we're going into the fire to pull out life lessons learned from frontline professionals and apply them to fire protection, business, and most importantly, everyday life. This week we're going to be talking to Christine Panas. Chris is a former firefighter from the Clandeboy Fire Department, and she has a great story to share with us about perseverance and achieving your goals. Let's have a listen to Chris's story.
Hi, my name is Christine Panas. I was on Clandeboy Fire Department for 8 years, and I just want to tell you a little story about persistence and some of the struggles and challenges I had on the department. It was, of course, a struggle of being one female of 25 male workers on the fire department. So just getting on was a struggle in itself. It took me a couple of years of applying and trying to get on, and finally they accepted my application. And of course I had to go through my level one training, just as all firefighters do. So when I got on the department, I was issued my gear, which my boots were about two sizes too big for me. My turnout gear was from a previous firefighter who was, of course, a little bit larger than me, but I never complained. I just wore my gear as I should and went through all the proper training and standard procedures and things like that. And when it came time for some of the challenges, like learning how to put on your SCBA and that, I felt I was kind of always looked upon like, okay, let's see if she can do it. And I never really got any help, so that made me want to try harder. And with everything that we had to do, I made sure I had to give that little extra effort and go maybe a little step further. If they said bring one, I brought two. If they said jump, I said how high. So I just wanted to make sure I passed the level one test, and never really was sure if I was accepted on the department. And it was always, okay, do they accept me? Do they not accept me? I always felt they were looking over my shoulder just to see if I could do it. And so gradually, as you know, a year or two went on, I managed to get my level one and pass my test, but still wasn't sure if I was accepted on the department. And one time we were sitting upstairs after fighting a couple grass fires, and the captain went to leave, and he went down the stairs and just said, okay, good night, guys. And we just all said good night, and then I can hear him coming back up the stairs, and he said, hey, Chrissy, when they called me Chrissy on the department, he said, when I say good night, guys, I mean you too. And I'm thinking, wow, like, that's pretty cool. I went, yeah, no problem. So that was one incident when I felt, oh, gee, maybe I'm finally kind of being part of this team. And then there was another incident a while later when it was a grass fire season, and as other firefighters can relate, it's very hard work, physically demanding, and you get call after call after call sometimes. And I was on a rural department, a farm country, so we had lots of fires that year, and we were about on our fourth call, and everyone was just exhausted. But of course, I'm not going to let up that I'm tired, by no means. So we were putting on our backpacks, and you know, I just went to load up again, and the fire was almost out, but we were just kind of doing one more last sweep, and I all of a sudden went to put my backpack on, and I just felt a little over the shoulder, a little help. So someone was behind me, and without even saying anything, I just kind of knew, okay, wow, like, finally felt a little bit more accepted, like one of the team finally, that wow, you know, they realize that I'm working just as hard as them. And so it was a struggle, and that's just my little story of perseverance, and kept trying, kept to prove that I could do it and could be just as strong, and worked out every day and went to the gym every day, and physically and mentally had to really show that I could keep up with the rest of the team, which I think I did. And like I said, they never really said it or had to say it, but it was just those little things along the line. And the moral of the story is not to give up and keep trying, and believe that you can do it. And doesn't matter who you are or how, if you're male or female, and if it's something you really want, and I wanted to be on that department really bad, so I did it.
Thanks, Chris, for that great story on setting goals and persevering through them. Now let's go into the fire and start talking about some of the great lessons that we can pull from Chris's story. First one, of course, is about fire protection. We always want to keep the fire protection close to our hearts here at Bison Fire Protection, so we'll dive into that one. And I want to talk about women joining the fire department and the work that Chris put in and how she has now inspired other women to join the force. She's talked to me about a couple other ladies that she knows that have gone through or are currently going through the training, how much work they're still facing to join. And guys, we have to remember that women want to be on the force because they want to give back to the community just as much as any other person. They have that desire to make their community a safer place, and that's why they want to be there. It isn't about equal rights or anything like that. They just want to serve. They truly do. We're seeing great women leading in the fire departments these days, and I look at, say, the director of fire prevention for City of Winnipeg, Janet Beer, and the fantastic work she's doing. She's so responsive in what she's doing, the policies that she's bringing forward. Probably one of the best directors that they've had in that division for years. But she's only one of many that are out there. There's ladies that are out working as inspectors. There's ladies that are working in public ed and doing a lot of great things for the fire department and doing a lot of great work in making the city a safer place through education. They are all contributing, and without them, I think we're losing a very positive dynamic that they bring to the workplace and what they bring to the fire departments. So guys, as you're sitting here listening to this right now, think about the different people that you've ran into and how they've changed the world and made it a better workplace. Like I say, if it's all guys, it's not a lot of fun out there because there's a different dynamic, a different way of joking with people when you've got ladies in the room as well, and they bring a great sense of humor. We want to have them there because they bring a new perspective. So now I want to talk about the business lesson and all the different things that come from that, because there's so many things that we can see that women bring to the business world. And I'm thinking about some of the strong women business leaders that I see out there. And right now I know Diane Gray with Centerport and the great job that she and her team are doing. And I know that Diane doesn't do it by herself. She's got a fantastic team around her, but she is certainly the person that helps drive it. I think of Mariette Muller and the great work she's doing over at the World Trade Center and the opportunities that she's creating for business. And how about the ladies over at Tiber River, who recently won the Women's Entrepreneur of the Year Award? And that was a panel that I was actually very proud to be judging on, but those ladies are just knocking it out of the park. Then I look at other business groups that are going on here in Winnipeg right now, and I'm thinking about the Winnipeg Chamber of Commerce, the board I sit on there, and how they have managed to find gender balance on that board. And sitting around the table and looking at both the men and women that are just bringing great ideas and fantastic suggestions and strong debate when we're thinking of different policies and the things that the chamber's working on, just being on that board and learning from those women has been a fantastic opportunity for me. I think about the Aboriginal Chamber of Commerce and the board there that I sit on and the amount of work that the ladies have done, and the Aboriginal Chamber has just crushed it this year. They've gone from being in the red to being in the black, and those ladies, the events that they've chaired that up, without them, that chamber would not have had the success that it's had. We are so fortunate to have the women there. You know, guys, I'm going to tell you, if you're out there and you're looking about building your business and thinking about how to grow it, you seriously need to be looking at the capable women that are there and the perspective that they bring to your business. If you really want to go to the next level, you need a rounded team. Rounded teams include women. Make sure that they're there. I've spent some time talking about some of the great women and the hard work that they've been doing in our community, but I also want to talk about goals and the persistence it takes to achieve them. Now, we've got a fella here that is an absolute machine when it comes to selling. He's knocking it out of the park day in and day out. And I'll tell you, it's because he gets a little dopamine rush every time he gets a sale. He feels great about it. He makes the team feel great, which again, it spreads. It's infectious what he does. And having that ability to share it, have the ability to make yourself and your team feel great is so important. So achieving a goal and having the persistence to make sure that you get there. We talk about the powers of having goals and goal setting, but that is absolutely critical to feeling good and building a strong team. So our last and most important lesson, of course, is the life lesson. How do we apply some of this stuff to ourselves at home in our regular lives? And I'm going to say, guys, when you start thinking about women in the workplace, those are our wives, our sisters, our mothers, our daughters, in some cases our grandmas. We have to make sure that they are going to work and enjoying what they're doing. They can contribute. Again, they have the same commitment to their job that anyone else does. They want to have success, and they deserve to have that same success. There's no good reason why we can't have women in the business place at every level, not just in the secretary pool or in the admin. I know here at Bison, we've had women at every level, you know, in senior management to supervisor to all kinds of different things. And I'm always glad to have them and always glad to have their perspective of what they bring because they see it through a different set of eyes than I do. One last point as we're getting ready to wrap up. Guys, as you're building your team, keep the eyes open for those strong women, those great leaders that can help you take your company to the next level. Having that diversity in your business is critical. So I want to thank Chris for sharing her story with us today. It sure gave me a lot to chew on as I was getting this show together. I mean, there's so much to talk about. Thanks again, Chris. Do you have a personal fire story you want to share? Reach out with it. I think we can really do something with a great story. You never know when it'll burn its way into the fire. Now, I know you learned something from today's episode. Do your friends and family a favor by sharing it. Together, we can make the world a safer place. I'm Rob Reed. See you next week on Into the Fire.